they're young. So they do have to fight faster. Remember, you'll see when you get to attack while their shields are up. We need to get to that watchtower. We'll have to go through the valley, this way.
I know your son's story. You should know my daughter's. In the service of a cruel god, I was tricked into destroying a village, not knowing my own wife and child were there until their blood stained my hands. I swore revenge.
That's... I can't imagine.
I paid back their blood 1,000 times and burned Olympus to the ground. Yet, the guilt remained. Perhaps you will kill me, Freya. But it will bring you no peace.
Perhaps it is not peace I seek. All those times I found you, why'd you refuse to fight me?
Every outcome would mean defeat.
What does that mean?
I have never wished you harm, Freya. You helped us. You saved Atreus when he was sick. I did not wish to live with killing you any more than I wished to die.
I see. You hear that? Noken! And so close to the village! Their song makes their allies invulnerable! They will not let you pass unless you destroy them all! I hardly recognize it. I used to play hide and seek with Freya in the crops. We'd spend afternoons stealing honey bread from the Grand Hall. At harvest time, we'd dance and feast until the sun rose. It was all so simple. Why did I come back here? I'd be reminded of all this. The Grand Hall. It's in ruin.
Ugh! Oh!
Freya never waver.
The other half is missing. May she protect us always. An old adage, if you will. I hear them inside. Get ready to clear them out. It wasn't enough what Odin did to me. He's desecrated every memory I have of home.
Be glad you have a home to remember fondly. In Sparta, we were taken from our homes as children and raised in the Agoi. We marched or we drowned, fought for scraps or starved. Our elders beat us till we could not stand. At night, we made our way home, alone, or were food for wolves. That is how Spartans are made.
These plants behave similarly to the scorn poles we found in the foothills of Midgard ages ago. Well, considering how Spartans are made, it's no wonder you turned out as you did. Your fate was sealed from the start.
Fate can be overcome.
I used to think so. When the Norns told me of my son's fate, I thought I could change it. You know well how that worked out.
The Norns, the fates of these lands.
That's right. You defy prophecy at your own peril.
Atreus would agree with you about prophecy. He rushes blindly to a fate the giants foretold. Disappears for 2 days, trying to prove he is their champion, fabled to fight at Ragnarok.
What? I know all the Ragnarok prophecies. There's no champion of the giants.
It is one Gror concealed. Because of this champion, the realms are saved at Ragnarok. Only Asgard falls, and Odin with it.
So all this time, Odin's obsession with every detail of Ragnarok, he's been missing a crucial piece. Huh. Well done, bro.
Atreus will not be a pawn of prophecy.
You still stand against fate, even with victory foretold.
I will not march my son to war. He is no Spartan. I would keep it that way.
You would speak to me of protecting your child? Is my tragedy not enough of a lesson? Fighting fate is a waste of the precious time we're given to spend with them. You never know when someone will come along and cut it short. Can you swing that torch to the other side and burn the bramble blocking your path? You can probably use those islands to get a better angle on the torch, you know? Use your blade to swing the torch to the other side. Let's cross the bridge now. Anyone alive be squeamish about war? After all the gods we've killed.
I have seen enough war to know the cost.
And I do. The price I paid to end one? Look around. Don't do this. See what happens when you don't fight a tree. That's one of Odin's captains. Be ready.
Anskotar Asgardar!
Go!
I am reaching my limit for enlightened platitudes from you today. Can you please just shut up and kill things? Let's go. Well, that did it.
Ugh!
Tell me to kill again.
What?
I killed to protect my son, to aid my friends. But I will be no one's monster. Never again.
You don't get to make that choice. Not with the debt you owe me.
I am not here for debts. I would always have helped you.
So much has been taken from me, and I'm just supposed to let it all go?
Freya.
Enough. Let's go. It's just past those doors up ahead. I feel the source of the magic keeping me in Midgard.
What is this place?
My home. I was born here. Hold on. Something's not right. Opinbera. World tree roots bound in Odin's damn knots. That's how he did it. Come on! Nito!
Creature! It belongs to Odin?
No. It protects Yggdrasil's roots, wherever they are. Bastard was counting on it. Keep at it! Don't just stand there! Move! I need to get to those roots! You have its attention now! Don't lose it! Knock it out! Don't let it hide! Use your legs, not your... It's still in the way! I need to get to those roots!
I know!
If I free the Vanaheim root, I can help you!
I can handle the creature! Focus on the roof!
I'm trying! That's it!
Hurry!
Finally!
You are free!
In Vanaheim, yes. But there are more hoops. She will guard them with her life.
Oh!
He's down. Done.
It's over. It's really over.
And now that you have what you seek,
I suppose this is the point where I forgive you, where I kill you.
Have you decided?
To be honest, I don't think I can do either. There's still a part of me that is so angry, and it'll always be. It'll always be angry. But no. You are not the one who needs to die. I do see that. Everything that's happened between us.
No need to explain. Not to me. Not for that. I do not regret saving your life. And never will. But the choice between life and death should have been yours to make. I should not have robbed you of that choice.